So if the caste is not applied properly, so these kind of the complications may happen. Swelling of tissue, impaired circulations, gangrene, plaster sores, excessive pain. Fretfulness means the patient behavior irritative. Patient's behavior has changed to be very irritative because continuously there is some itching or some irritation inside the caste is there due to any kind of that ulcer is there or any kind of that discomfort is there. Disturbed sleep, patient may have the sleep disturbs due to that continuous irritations, recurrent swelling over the distal part of the cast may be swells up, maybe due to that impaired circulations, or patient may have low grade fever. That is very important features. That if any patient of the POP caste after few days have continuous low grade fever, disturbed sleeps, fretfulness behavior, then you must open the cast and see there must be some kind of that ulceration or some kind of the wound may be there inside cast. So first treat that wound and then you just apply again the cast and you may create a small window in that cast so that you can dress that wound properly and soakage of the cast. That is also very important that plaster cast may have some soakage. So next, we discussing that close method of the fixations where the no operation, no surgical surgery is required to fix that of the immobilize that fractures. So here these are the methods, some operative implants which are usually used to fix that fracture segment internally after the opening after giving incision and open the fracture site and apply that implants is that steel wire, screw, K wire, plates, intramedullary nails to fix that fragments. First is the steel wire. These are used for the internal fixation of the small fracture, just like fracture of that toes or the fracture in the phalanx. So this wire is steel wire, 18 to 20 gauge, and the procedure can be performed under the ring block, under the local or the general anesthesia. So with the drill machine, that wire is inserted. You can see in this, there is the fracture segment, two segments. So first, correct that displacement and then insert this wire from here to here so that these segments immobilize properly. After 4 to 6 weeks, when the fracture is sticky and fixed, then the implants can be removed. Usually, these implants are made up of the stainless steel, cobalt chromium alloy or titanium alloy. Titanium is very light and very strong metal, so it is very much used for that these kind of the implants. But this titanium is very costly, so alloys are also useful. Mix a few metals to make one metal to make a material to manufacture these kind of implants. These are the screw. Okay, the metal is always same. These can be used to fix the small fragment of bone to the major bone. Okay, easily what happens when a small fragment of the bone is detached from a large bone, then to fix this small fragment to the major bone, these screw are usually used. Usually these kind of the fractures that avulsion fractures. We already had discussed when the very strong muscles is attached to the bony part of the bone, and it will sudden force in that muscles may cause that detachment of that small fragment of that bone from the major bone. That is called avulsion fractures. Or in the malleolus fracture, these are so to fix these fracture at the malleolus or the avulsion fracture, these screws very much, very much useful. This is the Krishna wire or the K wire, usually known for with the name of K wire. So these are the straight stainless steel wire, 1 to 3 mm in the diameter, and it is used to fixation of the small fracture of the hand and feet. Means if the fracture is not very involves the small part of the bone, means that at the end of the bone or the small bones of fracture, so that these wires are very much useful in that conditions. With the drill wire, the wire is passed through one segment to the other segment, and so that these immobilizations can be occur. Usually when that articular surfaces are involved, in that cases these K wire is very important in that metacarpal fracture or the metatarsal fractures, usually used for the not used for the long big bones. Intramedullary nails. These are hollow rod like made of stainless steel or the titanium alloys. These are introduced in the the medullary cavity of the long bones and comes in the various sizes and shapes. So these are the nails. You can see that intramedullary nails. The name itself is self-explanatory, that these nails are used in intramedullary space and specially used in the longer bones, in the femur, in the radio ulna, or in the humerus. So you can see that the tibio fibula. You can see in these pictures that this is the long bone. That this is the femur is there. And it is fracture from the shaft, so that these nails are inserted from here, from the lesser greater trochanter into intramedullary nail in the medullary cavity of that both fragments and up to here. These are inserted from here to here and fixed with the screws inside the cavity, so that complete bone becomes straight. And because they are inserted in the medullary cavity, so do not disturb that the healing process of the bone, because even the healed bone healed bone also contain the cavity, so this remains in that the cavity and be distant to the both fragment, so they can unite very firmly and very strongly, and may also be used in that where the segmental fractures are there. So these comes in different sizes and different shapes. These are the plates and screw. These are the different type of the plates which are used to fix that. These are also used for the long bones, and these can be fixed at the surface of the bone. Suppose this is the bone and it is fractured from some we don't want to insert our intermediate medullary nail, because the procedure will little longer and have little discomfort, so even have the complications also. Every procedure, every surgical procedure have the complications. But if you want to, your choice is to plate. So if suppose this is the fragment, it is fracture from here. So you can fix one plate, half side in the both fragments. So it keeps that fragment immobilized, and so that it enhances the healing procedures. This is also comes in the different sizes and different shapes, because the different body parts of the different bones have the different shapes. So for the different bones, they comes in the different sizes and different shapes in the markets. So this is the iron. These plates fixed with the screws to the fragments. So these are the some other surgical implants. These are the joints. You can see that hip joints and knee joints. are usually especially made from that titanium, and these are the surgical implants. So some special implants for the internal fixations are also used, single or combination. Okay, so the combination of two or more of the implant, whatever we discussed, that is screw, plates, nails. So single or combination of the implants can be used in the same person, in the same fracture, depends on the condition of the wounds. So there are few advantages and few disadvantages of these implants. So advantage of these implants are, with the use of the implants, there is a minimal requirement of the external immobilizations that allows early immobilization of the patients, less hospitalizations, and early sign of function in that part. Understand? Means when you internally fix that, internally give support and fix that fragments, so now there is no need of the long time hospitalization, long time bed rest is not required, because the such strong support is given to the fragment, so that patient may can mobilize very early, so that can reduce the complications after that reduce the complication and that reduce the time of rehabilitations. And the disadvantage of the implant is the most important and most dangerous complication is the infections. If any implants get infected, any procedure of inserting that intramedullary nailing, plating, or spring or clay or anything, and if that wound is get infected, then the infection goes into the cavity of the bone, intramedullary cavity of the bone, then patient developed osteomyelitis, and osteomyelitis is very difficult disease to treat. So always there is the risk and benefit. So you have to calculate the benefit and risk, and then you have to take the risk. So now come to the external fixations. So you can see in the picture there is a device where you can fix that a fragment externally, the internal fixation. Some cases internal fixation is not possible. In that cases, external fixation can be given to the patient. So the device by which the fracture bone is held in a frame from outside the limb. So this is the external fixator. Steel pins are passed through the bone and connected outside with a bar with the help of clamp. You can see that these steel pins are inserted from the bone here and here, and then these steel bars are attached with these pins with the help of the clamp. So this method used in the treatment of the open fracture, where internal fixation cannot be carried out due to the risk of infections. Because if the open fracture is there, then that there is the risk of the there is the, when we insert open and keep inside some implants, then there is the risk of the more risk of the infection. Here are the also in risk of the infections, but in that cases internal implants has more chance of the infection, post-operative infection. So usually used in that where the comminuted fracture are there, the multiple fracture are there, in that cases these this external fixations may be required. So now we have completed the stage of that second stage, that is definitive care. Now come to the third phase of that management. First phase was emergency care, second phase was the definitive care, and third phase is the rehabilitations. So the rehabilitation of the fracture part always begin with the at the time of injury and continue till the part regain the full function. Understand? You may hear the same type of sentence in the case of the wound healing, that healing starts at the time of the injury and continue till the complete wound heals. So here also that the rehabilitation is start at the time of injury.